I'm on I-21. National Salvation Army works all year long to help those in need. And now National Salvation Army Week is right around the corner. So we have Major Ernest Hall and Michelle Linton here to tell us more about this. Thank you both so much for coming in this morning.
Thank you for having us.
We really do appreciate your time. Major Hall, I want to start with you. So we understand the Salvation Army has a special occasion coming up this week. Tell us about it.
Right. National Salvation Army Week is very important to the Salvation Army. 1954, then President Eisenhower, thank you, went blank.
That's okay.
Designated that week, this week, you know, National Salvation Army Week, and we use this week as an opportunity to spread the word about the work we do. Mm-hmm. We're generally on the front lines doing so much, but not a lot of folks know exactly what we do each and every day, so this is our opportunity to spread that around.
You talk about some of the work you do. A lot of people know you for those red kettlebells. As soon as you hear them ringing, you know what time of year it is.
That's correct.
Let's talk about that, the red kettlebell campaign.
Certainly our biggest fundraiser of the year. You know, it's important to note that out of that, 82 cents of every dollar raised, you know, goes right to the programs in need. Those funds actually help us through much of the year to fund the operation we do. But that's what most people know us about. Certainly we do a lot more than that. You know, our main focus in our community is that of sheltering the homeless, reaching out to the homeless population. We have partners that we work with throughout the community. Love 365 Church. Is one that we partner with to actually go out to the homeless and feed them right on the streets. Mm-hmm. We do 2,000 meals a week with them, feeding the homeless out there. And it's a great ministry to be able to reach out to those individuals. And we do all of our work through the Homeless Center of Hope, where we help those women, men, and families who are homeless to go to a new place in their life, to be able to succeed.
Michelle, tell us a little bit more about the Center of Hope and the services that you all offer there.
Sure. Well, we do the emergency feeding and shelter, as Major said. We do service men, women, and children. The center is actually one of the largest general centers of shelters, and we can accommodate up to 261 individuals on any given night. We feed about 200 people just out of our Center of Hope kitchen. So there are a lot of services, but those are just quick interventions. So once they come in, we try to get them with a case manager mm-hmm. who can help them get on their road to self-sufficiency and never have to go back on the street ever again.
Incredible work that both of you do. Mm-hmm. How can people find out more both about the Salvation Army and the Center of Hope?
Well, you can go to our website. The website is salvationarmynola.org. We have some summaries about our services, but we really want people to come this week, Wednesday and Thursday, come to the Center of Hope for yourself, see it in action. We'll learn about services. You'll get to see firsthand of the shelter. It's a beautiful facility, mm-hmm. and no one happens to know that it's there, and nobody knows that we did all that we do in that little building, right? Well, it's a large building, but yeah.
There's the information there. May 15th and 16th, you will have 30-minute tours. They're scheduled from 9, 11, and 1. The address right there on your screen, 4526 South Claiborne Avenue. This is being called Behind the Red Shield, mm-hmm. so that people can get an idea more of some of the work and services that you both offer.
That's it. And it's not a fundraising opportunity. It's really just so that we can get the word out. Mm-hmm. You know, if people really get to see a picture behind the scenes of what we do, it's more compelling.
Yeah.
So they might open their purses later on. But, it's really about getting our story out there to those in the community to know that we are actually doing something important for the community.
Certainly. So Major and Michelle, thank you both for the work that you
do.
Thank you so much for your time today.